Laying Ghosts by Clare Reddaway, directed by Emily Wright.
Connie, do you want a lift with us? I just looked at the clock and I thought, oh, I haven't seen Gary's car. Perhaps he's not there yet. And you don't want to be late, do you? Connie?
No! I mean, yes.
So, is he on his way then?
He'll meet us there. He rang.
I expect he's stuck in traffic. Coming up from London, it's always terrible.
Yes, that's it.
So, you'll come with us, will you, love?
Thank you.
Oh, could you not find your black?
My Jack liked me in this. I wore it for our silver wedding. He said I looked a picture.
Oh, there you are, love. You have a good cry. It'll make you feel better. Tony, I'll get in the back here with Connie. She needs a shoulder at a time like this.
Oi, Gary.
What?
Slow down.
I don't want to be late.
Late for what? Gary? Oh, never mind.
Connie, love, everyone's sitting ready and waiting. They should have brought the coffin in 10 minutes ago. I think they need to get their skates on. Connie?
But Gary's not here.
No. Well, he can join us, can't he? In the middle. No law against that, is there?
All right. Perhaps it's for the best.
Where are we?
It's a crematorium.
Yeah? What are we doing here?
I have to go to a funeral. My dad's funeral. Oh, no. I should have told you.
Yeah. To which bit should you have started with, then? Oh, Sandra, my dad's dead. Or, oh, Sandra, do you fancy coming to my dad's funeral? To which I would have said, no, thanks, Gary, but thanks for asking. What didn't you say?
I don't know. It never seemed like the right time. The thing is, no, we're here now, I've got...
No! Look at me.
Well, I think you look wicked.
But not, you know, right for a funeral.
Please.
Oh, come on then, Tiger.
Jack was always first
I'll
in.
I'll just slip in here.
No.
Leader of the pack, we called him.
With my mum.
Where the fire was worst, that's where he'd be. He had no fear.
This is Sandra.
He was a lion.
I'm sorry for your loss, Miss Peterson. Excuse me.
A lion of a man. And a staunch supporter of Peatling Rugby Club. He will be sorely missed.
All rise. Hymn number 680.
Time heals all wounds, eh? Is what they say.
Yes, they do.
Perhaps it was for the best in the long run. Better to go quick, that's what I'd like.
Oh, would you? On the bathroom floor with your head rammed up against the toilet?
Well, there's no need for... Oh, is that Malcolm over there? I need a word with him. Can I get you anything, Connie, love? What do you think you were playing at, Gary? Late and with that...
That what?
That girl. Don't you think your mother's got enough to cope with?
She's gorgeous, though, isn't she?
Yeah, if you like that sort of thing.
What? You mean black?
That's not what I said. You know what I mean. Her standing there with a skirt up round her ass. Why do you always twist things? I don't know. Connie, love, let me get you a drink. Now, you know that if there's anything I can do, anything at all...
I'll start on the washing up then, shall I?
I'll grab a bin bag.
Your dad would have been pleased, wouldn't he?
What do you want me to do with the cake? Not much left. Mop in it, shall I?
It was a good turnout, wasn't it? And your Uncle James looked well. Lots came from the station.
Do you want a crisp, Mum?
No. No, I do not want a crisp. Gary, love, just sit down, will you?
Mum, look, I'm...
Just for a minute.
I'm just trying to get this place in some kind of order. Sort it out.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.